Class 6, welcome on board. We have a science lesson. I'm going to take you through animal feeds. Like human beings, animals do feed, and they feed on either grass or other feeds that we buy from shops. And that's what I want to take you through, that for animals to have good production is can be equated to the type of diet. For proper production, the diet is very important. For strong health in the animal, or the animal health, highly depends on the feeds it takes. And therefore, we want to say that, we want to start by saying the types, to discuss the types of animal feeds, In the types of animal feeds, I wish to take you through different types. One, we have one type known as the pasture. We have pasture as one of the type of animal feeds. We also have what we call fodder. We have the fodder. We also have what we call commercial feeds. These are the three main examples of all main types of animal feeds. We have the pasture, we have the fodder, we also have the commercial feeds. Pasture, to start with, pasture is very simple to understand. It's very simple for us to understand. What is pasture? Pasture is a piece of land set aside for animals to graze. So, land set aside for grass to grow, or animal types of grasses or some legumes for animals to grow. For example, if this is a home shed, this is your home, or this is a home area, then this land is reserved for animals, for grass to grow for the animals. This land is what you call the pasture. Then we have, in the pasture you can have several types of grasses growing or several types of legumes. So pasture is where the animal feeds directly from the field. Then we go to the fodder. Fodder is slightly different from pasture. And that is how, this is the main difference. In fodder, it is when it is harvested grass from the land. If this was a pasture land, someone gets into this farm, cut the grass, or you clear the grass and store or take directly to the animal for feeding, we say harvested pasture is fodder. So fodder is harvested grass. Harvested pasture or harvested grass. Harvested grass or legumes. There are people who harvest and they feed it to the animal directly. That is known as direct fodder. There are people who harvest fodder and store it so that they can feed the animals later. They can either store it dry, and when it is stored dry, we say it is known as hay. And it is stored in bales. You cut the grass, you put it somewhere to dry. When it turns brown, it is made into bales, then stored in that dry mode. That dry grass is known as hay. It is mainly conserved. Hay is a conserved fodder. Then there are others who will store it while still green. We call it the silage. What they do is that they just make a cemented pit. They cut the fodder from the pasture land when it is still green. They come and they empty it inside here. Then they press it hard to remove air. It is hard pressed to remove air, because air is needed by bacteria in the decomposing process. If the air was to remain here, this folder, this silage would decay, because remember that the plants were stored still green. So they have to place it hard to ensure that the air gets out of that green folder, that silage. Then from there, they add some preservative. You add some preservative. No, they mainly add molasses to preserve it. You add the preservative, then they cover it. It is stored. They don't give it time to dry. It is cut, chopped into small pieces, put inside here, then pressed to remove air so that it cannot decompose. Then they add preservative. That fodder, these two, the silage and hay, are fodders which have been which are conserved. So we call them the conserved fodder. The conserved fodder. Conserved fodder is an example of fodder. The last one are the commercial feeds. The commercial feeds are bought in shops. The commercial feeds are bought in shops. And the people who prepare the commercial feeds, they just mix some maize, maybe maize jam. They mix the maize jam and maybe something, and then they add what you call concentrates. They add what you call concentrates. From the word concentration, you get the word concentrates. What they do, an animal can eat maize jam, because maize jam are maize stalks that have been crushed into powder form. But the animal cannot take the concentrate. I want to define what a concentrate is. A concentrate are substances added, are substances added to commercial feeds, added to commercial feeds. Commercial feeds to increase the nutritional value, the nutritional value, the nutritional value. Let me bring it out. Let me try to bring it out better. What I mean by this is, it is not possible for a cow to eat bones, but I can grind bones to form what you call a bone meal. So I collect bones from many places, take them to a grinding place, grind them into powder form, then add to maize jam. The cow will not recognize that I crushed the bones. So this bone is rich in calcium. Therefore, it has added the nutritional value. So bone meal is rich in calcium. Then we have, I can get what the omena, fish. Then I crush them in powder form to form what we call a fish meal. Well, after crushing, this one will be rich in one, calcium, because they had bones. There will be calcium in that, in those small fillets. Then number two, there will be protein because they had meat. There will also be vitamin. Therefore, it will be an additional nutritional value. We can also have the sunflower seeds. A cow cannot feed on sunflower seeds. Therefore, we crush them to get oil and protein. These addictive substances are what I'm calling the concentrates. They are added to commercial feeds. NB, to sum it up, we also have cotton seeds, add the same way as the sunflower, the cotton seeds. NB, commercial feeds are mainly given to increase production. They are mainly given. These ones, you give them to increase production. If you want to increase production in a cow, you give commercial feeds. They are also given to supplement other feeds, like the fodder and the pasture. I have given more notes below below this video. Therefore, interact more and learn more. Otherwise, have a good time.